2023 has proven to be a rather challenging year for the investing world, with numerous central banks raising interest rates to tamp down inflation and worsening geopolitical conflicts dampening sentiment in general. Now, as we approach the end of the year, ANC's very own Salve Duplito sat down with Ruben Zamora of Metro Bank to discuss what lies ahead for investors in 2024. Here's that interview.
Salve Duplito. Welcome to a special edition of ANC's On the Money. Looking forward to 2024, we are thinking about where to invest in 2024 and how do we identify areas of growth and innovation. And these are crucial in making informed decisions about where to allocate resources. To talk to us about investment opportunities and business outlook for the coming year, let's welcome Ruben Zamora. He's the head of Institutional Investors Coverage Division at Metro Bank. Thank you for being here in the studio with me.
No, now, thank you for having me.
Let's look at how investors invested in 2023.
In 2023. Yeah, no, it was a tough investment climate this year because interest rates, when they go up, and they went up very quickly and to a certain extent, much more than people expected. That tends to hurt equities and stocks and bond investments. So in general, you know, it's been a tough environment for investments in 2023.
The environment is really changing, and the expectation is that equities will do better in 2024. What are you seeing? What's on your crystal ball?
The crystal ball. So 2024, I think it's going to be, we're quite constructive. We're quite positive on risk assets and Philippine risk assets in general in 2024. We kind of favor bonds still going into the beginning part of next year. But we'd also be quite favorable in accumulating some positions in equities, patiently over the
so
next year.
So not all in one go.
Please, not all in one go.
So you're going to choose some, maybe start putting in money in what month? Around March?
It kind of depends a little bit. What we're really waiting for is when interest rates start looking like they're going to fall, because 2023 was all about interest rates rising, rising very, very quickly. But I think in 2024, there are already signs that interest rates will start easing, what we call an easing cycle. But it starts really with the central banks across the world, and of course led by the U.S., and the Banco Central obviously is watching what the rest of the world and what the U.S. Fed will do in 2024. Our expectation is that they might start looking at easing rates pretty much around maybe late Q1, that's the earliest, maybe in March, or maybe around early second quarter, and then gradually kind of taking kind of the foot off the brake a little bit next year. So that should help stocks.
And some of the indicators that you're looking at, so that you know our viewers can guide themselves on how to do it, earnings outlook.
I think going into next year, we're still going to face certain inflation headwinds. I think Governor Remolona is quite mindful of the risks of inflation, again, because we have El Nino
right.
and that is a big factor in food. Food is a big part of Philippine inflation, rice in particular. So there are administrative solutions, fixes for those. But if prices are still high, it's going to be difficult for rates to
come down. When the shift happens, which sectors are you looking at? Where do you put your money?
Banks tend to do well in high interest rate environment. It helps margins and protect margins. But I think some of the defensive sectors, utilities, some of the higher paying dividend companies like the telecom companies, those tend to be very defensive, and therefore, you know, when earnings are starting to kind of pick up, that's when you maybe want to take a look at other sectors. But those are the sectors that will continue to do well, I think, while interest rates are still where they are.
Are there any risks that it might go up further next year?
We don't think so. We've been of the view that the last hike of the U.S. Federal Reserve was in July. It didn't look like it was, but we were sticking to that view, and it turned out to be the right view. The Banco Central did hike on October 30th. I think because the Governor Remolona and the authorities.
This was off cycle, right?
It was an off cycle hike, yeah, on October 30th. And I think it's really just more, you know, recognizing that the inflation remains an issue. And I think there's still the main function of this of the central bank to be inflation hawks, to be watchful of inflation.
So what would be your advice for sophisticated investors? How exactly can they navigate 2024 so that they make more returns in 2023?
Things are quite volatile. I think there's a lot of things can happen to disrupt markets. We saw that just like last October when the Middle East conflict happened. And of course, March this year, you know, Silicon Valley Bank and the collapse of that, the regional U.S. banks, you know, those are risks that you need to be watching for, and how markets behave, and risk assets are exposed. That's why they're called risk assets, because they're exposed to those types of risks. I think as we go through 2024, nothing's certain.
Oh, gosh.
It still remains uncertain.
We're hoping, but
yeah, we want we think
information is so important in this day and age when you're invested. What kinds of specific information can we expect when we check out Wealth Insights so that we know exactly what to do?
It's a portal for really investors, anyone who wants to invest and you know, make money from their investments.
Both
or manage
global
risk
and local?
We have to look at global.
All major markets?
Yes, we have to look at global because it, you know, everything's connected. And local, of course, is the main focus because we are trying to look after the local investor community. So from, you know, from the novice all the way to the sophisticated. So, you know, there's a lot of jargon in financial press. We need to kind of figure out what they really mean. So we spend a lot of time on that as well, in explaining some of that terminology, but really connecting all of that and tying it into something, and tying it together into something that you should do, an actionable idea.
So Ruben, question is this available to everyone?
Yes, Wealth Insights is available to everyone. We have a public site that you can read all our ideas and our views and commentary. It's up to date. We watch markets 24/7. So if there's something that's important, well, you know, when we wake up, we look at markets right away. We watch you guys. So things that matter. So we put it out there. We do want to look after, again, the Filipino investor. That's one of the things that's important for us. You know, you're in good hands. That's our promise. So that's available. That's on wealthinsights.ph. So that's easy to remember, hopefully. So please go visit it and hopefully, you know, get a chance to understand what's going on out
right.
there.
I think this is where I read the barbell strategy in 2023.
Yes, we wrote about it. Yeah, it's out there. It's out in the public website. So, please, and feel free to ask us questions as well. You can contact us. But we do have exclusive content as well for MetroBank clients.
It's a huge need, Ruben, because the markets are very noisy. We all need curation. We all need to be directed to what we should read, what are the things that actually matter. So that they're not noise. But so maybe this is a very difficult job and you're doing it. Why?
Yeah, no, we're trying to cut through all that noise. And we're doing that work for you on Wealth Insights. We want to help and empower the local investor. There's so many, all markets are interconnected. It's hard to navigate.
Getting access to local and global news.
Yeah.
I think your team is awarded for this, right?
No, thank you. Yes, yes. So we have we've been lucky in earning some global and local recognition for the work we've done. I think that's hopefully the product of hard work, and we'll continue to, you know, garner those and accomplish those. But again, for us, what matters is making sure that you're looked after, that you're in good hands as the Filipino investor. I think that's why we spend so much time trying to, you know, tie everything together. And at the end of what we're telling you, this is what we think you should be doing with your investments. Mm-hmm. You know, both in terms of helping you create wealth, but also helping you manage risk.
And protect that wealth.
And protect that wealth, mm-hmm. exactly.
Thank you so much for the great work that you're doing on a financial education, Ruben. Thank you so much.
Thanks so much, Salve.
That's all we have for today. I'm Salve Capito for ANC's On The Money.